Welcome to video 27 on the Yamaha Montage and Modix synthesizers. In the previous video we made a recording which resulted in a MIDI file. In this video we'll do the same, make a recording, but this time we'll create an audio file which will become a .wav file. We can start with any performance that we like to record. I chose one that has a couple of arpeggios, the one we made in video 25. And let's tap the record play field over here and enter the recording screen. These are the three recording modes, and this time we are going to select audio. What we see right now is that it says please connect a USB device. Well, this is because that's the place where it is going to save our recording. There's one issue. I have connected the video, so I cannot connect an audio device at the same time. So I will have to stick to showing some pictures in the video instead of doing this live. All right, back here with images of the screens, nothing live. What we see over here, the name field, in this case it's empty, and in other cases there could be a file name already mentioned here. But if we want to make a new recording, it's good practice to not overwrite anything and give it a name, a new name first. So let's tap that name field, and then something a little bit counterintuitive happens. We can't give it a new name, we only can tap a load field. And when we do that, we enter the file manager of the USB stick, and the content type is already conveniently put at WAV file automatically. We can create a new audio file by tapping this field, or we could load an existing WAV file and play it back. We are going to tap the new audio file field, and then we can give our file a name, and then we tap done. Then we are in the recording screen with the new name of our file that we are still going to record. Well, to record it's quite simple. All we have to do is press the record button on the synth that will start blinking in red. Then that only arms the recording. We also have to press the play button and it will light up green, and that's the moment the recording starts, and then we immediately can start to play and it will record everything we play. There's nothing more to it than this. If we are done recording, we press the stop button and that's done. It will automatically save it on the USB stick. There's no count in, it's not MIDI, it doesn't know how fast we are going to play. So what you always get is that little gap without any sound from the moment you press the play button until we start playing. If we want to get rid of that, there is an option to do that. Press or tap this trigger level field, and there we can enter a number. Say we enter the number 10 or more, it doesn't really matter. And that means that the recording will automatically start when we press the play button. It does not immediately start the record, it only starts recording when the sound level exceeds the trigger level. And if you use a low number, not too low that listens to noise, but if you use a low number like 10, it will always start the recording automatically. And that means you have no gap at all. Recording starts the moment you start to play. Well, this is actually all there is to it. When the recording is done, it is automatically saved on the stick, and we can press play to play it back, and then we can of course play along. It is playing a WAV file, an audio file, and we can use the keyboard to do whatever we like. We can of course also load existing WAV files. You can download some from the internet and then play along. So when we tap the name and then tap that load field, then now we have here a WAV file, as we can see. So if I want to load this WAV file, tomorrow or next week, then simply tap it, it will load and we can play it. This is it, the audio recording. Quite straightforward and simple. The next video, well, I probably think it's a good moment to have a look at that third option for recording, and that was the pattern recorder. And that is a sort of a beast that can do a little bit more. It is a sort of a sequencer that can be used.